the name of Jesus Christ. Your faith is your protection. May the grace of God reach you. May His anointing touch you. Distance is not a barrier. Receive the anointing of the Holy Spirit. May your life be transformed. Your life be changed. In Jesus Christ, my friend. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, I love worship. I love worship. Hallelujah. Praise Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
That's from the bottom of our hearts. Motivated by truth and spirit. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
This is the kind of a heart that God is looking for. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You get lost in His presence. Forget who you are.
You
forget who you came with. Praise the Lord Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
You will forget your attire or your makeup whatsoever. It is your heart that the Lord is seeking after. Praise the Lord Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
We are going straight to the word of God. Without a waste of time. God's time is the best. Look at your clock and say, time is gone. But God knows why. He's like this today. Praise the Lord Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
He fashioned our lives in His hands. Praise the Lord Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
I feel the point of the Holy Ghost in this place. Your life will never be the same again. I'm saying your life will never be the same again. Believe God. You will be established. Hallelujah. Believe God. Praise the name of Yeshua. Say Allah to Jesus. Let's prepare for the praise and worship team. And I want to thank God the time we had with the youth yesterday. And I want to encourage every young person to attend the following Saturday. We shall be there to teach one another about the matters of the kingdom and how should we live as young people. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
There was not much of you yesterday. But as I'm announcing, I'm hoping that next Saturday we shall meet all together. Praise the name of the Lord Christ.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
The book of Joshua. Chapter number 13. It's our communion service today. So we have to prepare our hearts by the word of God and through repentance. Hallelujah. I don't know, maybe this thing, it happens in me only. When you get deeper in worship, in the presence of God, you see yourself as not worthy to be there. You see yourself as a sinner who is not worthy to be there. And instead of asking money and cars and all these things, you find yourself repenting. You find yourself asking Him to bless you. That's what the presence of God does when it comes. Because The closer you get to Him, the more you feel His holiness. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And the more you feel this, you are not waiting for you to be there. This is grace. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So now you realize that it is your heart and your soul that God is after. And you ask Him to bless you of whatsoever thing that might hinder you. Praise the Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
That is why worship is so important in church. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
And as I said, even the instrument must be well organized and perfect.
Because
the Bible says with our voices, with the cymbals and instruments of strings, we have to worship Him. Sound plays an important role in our soul. Sound. It's very important. That's why even the devil knows how important sound is. Look at the worldly music out there. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah. So when you feed your soul with a heavenly sound, when you feed your soul with heavenly sound, it has power to prepare your soul through your emotions. Praise the Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
And you will feel the presence of the Almighty overwhelming you. Praise the Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So whatever you listen, it is stored in your subconscious mind. And you might begin to interpret it. So you begin to live that kind of lifestyle. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I mean, you look at your brothers who follow after hip hop music. All of a sudden, their trousers goes down a little bit. And no one is telling them that.
That's
the kind of music they are listening to. So Satan knows the power of music. Remember, it was angel Lucifer who was responsible for worship in heaven. Hallelujah.
Amen.
That's why I get angry. When you pass by the tavern, the sound is very clear and nice. But when you go to church, even when you hear the sound, it takes you years.
Yet
you find believers, it's expensive, we
cannot
buy. You find people from Pinal coming to Banyamaza. We
heard
sound inside. Satan is tricking.
Satan is tricking.
We need to ask God to give us grace to understand sound. When I meditate, I play sound as my background. Praise the Lord Jesus Christ. Sound. It is not about your situation, but what you will do in it.
Tell
me about That is the title of our message. It is not about your situation, but what you will do in it. Praise the Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Say, I love my Father.
I love you, my
Say, I love my Lord.
I love you, my Lord.
I want us to read verses number 1. Chapter number 13.
Such in Matthew Joshua 13, verse number 1. Now Joshua was old, advanced in years. And the Lord said to him, you are old, advanced in years, and there remains very much land yet to be possessed. This is the land that yet remains.
Verse 1 for me. Hallelujah. Another version. Yes.
Oh my,
Sarah was very old when she conceived.
what you will do in your situation. Look at this, somebody. Look at this. You are very old and advanced in age. Yet there is still much learning for you, Joshua, to possess.
Yeah. Oh, what shall be?
You don't have a house, you don't have a car.
Oh, no, 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 no.
Look at them and say, my life is in the hands of God. The Alpha and the Omega.